Let's talk about divorce in 5 minutes. I'm Bill Gentry. I'm a divorce and family lawyer in Marietta, Georgia, and we practice throughout the metro Atlanta area. What I'd like to do now is spend about 5 minutes talking about divorce law and process to help you understand it really in a nutshell. In a divorce case, there are five issues really that we have to talk about. Number one is the grounds for the divorce. Now, the vast majority of divorce cases are granted simply for the reason that the marriage is broken and can't be fixed, although there are other fault-based grounds such as infidelity, habitual drug use, cruel treatment, and so forth. I generally tend to suggest folks just put it in the grounds that the marriage is broken and can't be fixed because your divorce papers are public records open to inspection by anybody with an internet access. The second two issues really are kid issues. The first is custody and the second is child support. Custody itself has two parts. There's physical custody, which is where are the kids day to day, hour to hour. The second is legal custody. Who makes final decisions for the four legal custody areas? Education, health, extracurricular, and religion. Let's turn to child support for a minute. Child support generally is calculated based on the income of mom and dad and how many kids there are and what other expenses there may be for the kids. The other two issues, fourth and fifth, are alimony, spousal support, and division of property and debts. With alimony, it's falling out of favor. A lot of judges are just less inclined to award it now than they used to be, but in the right case, alimony is still possible. Alimony can be obtained, for example, where mom stays home and raises three or four kids, dad goes off to work, and the fact that mom dedicated her time to raising these kids means that dad really has undertaken a commitment to keep supporting mom while dad's career is taken off and he's making lots of money. Now, of course, sometimes these roles are reversed. Mom is the one going off with the great career and dad is the one staying home. Finally, we get to division of property and debts. And really, it's about the marital accumulation of property and debts from the date of the marriage to the date of the divorce. So if you had a bunch of stuff from before the marriage, or if you inherit from somebody else a bunch of property, grandma passes away and leaves you $50,000, that's your separate property. What's accumulated with the sweat during the marriage, the equity, the work during the marriage, that goes on the table and is subject to being divided by the judge or by agreement at the end of the divorce. Typically, we start with 50-50, but it doesn't have to be a 50-50 scenario. It can be 40-60, 30-70, depending on bad conduct or good conduct of either party. So that's the divorce process, or the divorce law. The divorce process really falls into three categories. There's the initial statement of the divorce, which is what are the issues? There's discovery of all of the information. And then there's resolution. Let's talk about each of those in a little more detail. The initial process is, are there children involved? Is someone fighting for custody or parenting time or legal decision-making for these kids? The second part of the process is to be sure everybody has all the relevant information. Has dad got a big 401k? Has mom got a pension? Has someone been unfaithful, which might disqualify them from alimony? Have any of those things occurred? Once we have all that information, we have the analysis and the division, whether it's by mediation or by a final trial. That's the divorce process in summary. Now, it can take as little as a few months or even a couple of years, depending on how hard people fight, how much money's at stake, and what these issues are. That's the divorce process in a nutshell.